This is Paper Mario. I assume many of you are familiar with this guy, and one of his most recognizable defining traits. He's flat. However, a lesser known trait of his is that he's actually not. Okay, obviously, not all Paper Mario games convey their characters like this. The very first Paper Mario game obviously just had regular 2D sprites. And more modern titles, such as Color Splash and Origami King, completely abandon the 2.5D skeletal models in favor of more static sprites. This 2.5D skeletal technique was most nobly present in the Thousand Year Door Adventure Remake in Super Paper Mario. Less commonly acknowledged, however, is that it was also present in 3DS games, probably to keep Tetris space smaller. Anyway, I actually quite enjoy this 2.5D style of animation, and I wanted to see if I can make an approachable implementation of this with Godot's 2D skeletal systems. There is a problem with this approach, however. You see, Godot's 2D and 3D renderers are very much separated from one another, unlike some other engines, like Unity. This is quite a boon for more lightweight and specialized implementations, but less so for my goal of having it in 3D, as I can't exactly drag it into a 3D scene. There are ways to work around this, however, like using a sprite 3D node with a viewport texture of the 2D skeletal rig, but that can throw in potential performance problems with multiple instances. Plus, this also has some visual limitations compared to the actual 3D models that Paper Mario uses, like applying custom spatial materials. So I thought, why not try to figure out a way to convert a 2D skeletal setup into 3D? You see, it's entirely possible in the Godot game engine to dynamically generate 3D meshes of code. In the Polygon 2Ds, the 2D meshes that Godot's 2D skeletal systems use have all their mesh data exposed to be easily accessed via code. So, with this in mind, I knew it should be entirely possible to recreate these meshes in 3D. It's just a matter of implementation. After some initial prototypes and some feature updates, this is the system that I've come up with. Introducing the PaperSkeleton add-on. How it works is that it introduces a new PaperSkeleton node, and with it, you select a parent node containing your Skeleton 2D's group of Polygon 2Ds, and it will accurately recreate the whole rig in 3D. It'll also convert the Polygon 2D nodes into Paper Polygon 2D nodes, and the Bone 2D nodes into Paper Bone 2D nodes. These are used to store and pass in certain information to make configuration of the PaperSkeleton rig much easier. Anyway, these two node types have a large influence over the PaperSkeleton rig. Changes in the Paper Polygon 2D's properties will result in it being accurately updated in real time, including UV offsets, textures, and other things. Much of this is thanks to the custom shader materials that the 3D meshes use to properly convey this data. More on custom shaders later. Changes in position, rotation, and scale will also be reflected in the 3D skeleton. The only unfortunate exception to this is skew transformations, as Godot's Skeleton 3D cannot and possibly will never support shearing. The most I can offer is a flawed imitation, but personally, I just generally avoid any skew transformations in any animations. Now, these are the primary features of PaperSkeleton, but there's a lot more features than that, so let me just go through them real quick. Firstly, Paper Bone 2Ds also come with bone modifiers. In the off chance you want your PaperSkeleton bones to extrude into 3D space, you can just select a Paper Bone 2D and adjust the modifier as such. There's also built-in cylindrical billboarding, which allows the PaperSkeleton rig to always face the camera. To more manually set the camera for it to face, the camera override can also be selected. Whether you want the PaperSkeleton rig to face towards the position or rotation of the camera can also be defined. And then here's Flip and Paper Rotate Flip. Flip's functionality is, you know, obvious. However, Paper Rotate Flip is a bit different. In earlier versions of this add-on, the Paper Rotate Flip slider's main functionality was to gradually invert the space between meshes as the paper skeleton rotates, so that a smooth flip animation can still be initiated without need to see the model's ugly side. Eventually though, I realized that this could just be entirely mitigated with a more versatile view-based shader. The slider is still useful for inverting the aforementioned bone modifiers and has compatibility with billboarding. Certain specifics of this behavior can be toggled here. And for another feature, you know how characters like Luigi have an L on their hat, but it isn't weirdly flipped around in the Paper Mario game? This is because that hat specifically has two different textures, one for front and one for the back. This is also supported in the add-on by assigning the flip texture in the Paper Polygon 2D as 3D mesh equivalent corresponding kind, showing off the texture on the other side. Now, many of these features are allowed thanks to the PaperSkeleton specialized shader, but you can actually throw in your own custom ones as well. PaperSkeleton allows you to configure and assign your own custom shaders for your own special effects. You can set the shader configuration for the whole PaperSkeleton rig, or set individual overrides for each mesh. You can also input shaders as the next pass, which allow for things like custom borders. The add-on comes with a couple of examples, including a recreation of the Thousand Year Door Remake's fake depth effect. If you have a specially customized shader configuration set up, you can save your configuration to a special file and reload it later. Each preset is designed to only work for the specific kind of PaperSkeleton rig it was set up with though, so just keep that in mind. To make some aspects of shader configuration easier, Paper Polygon 2Ds also come with a couple of extra properties. There's Polygon to copy group index of, a bit of a mouthful, but it's basically a separate index that some shaders can take advantage of to group certain meshes together in a separate pass, which is useful for making things like the aforementioned fake depth effect. Without it, the effect looks like this. There's also the custom texture maps array, which makes assigning special custom texture maps for each individual mesh a much smoother process than manually applying certain shader configurations. And that's PaperSkeleton. It's currently on itch.io, and you can check it out in the link below. I'm selling it for $10. Please buy it. I do intend to keep improving on this add-on and patching any reported bugs. The add-on is technically finished, but some things I plan on making easier are setting up separate rigs of forwards and backwards directions, swapping between many texture sets for the sake of animation, and being able to override those texture sets to support alternate skins. When those release, I also plan on making update videos regarding them, so subscribe if you'd like to see that. Oh, and also, make sure to check out @knifefunart on Twitter. She designed and drew this little dragon skeleton guy. You can actually play around with the little guy on the itch.io page, as there's the little demo on it that you can mess with. Anyway, I hope you all enjoyed the video. Please buy it.